So good evening everyone. So today in this video we are going to discuss about the Bajaj Finance share. So recently we have seen from the past week that Bajaj Finance has been falling continuously, and also later it started recovering, but again it started falling, and recently it has given 10% dip also, but today it has given around 5.19% upward movement. So will it continue its uptrend, or again is there any reversal possible? So we'll find out that in the charts. We'll also see the various supports as well as the resistances for the nearby price. Okay, so basically I have done analysis on the Bajaj Finance using the option chain analysis to find out maximum how much upward movement it can give in 1 month, as well as annually how much upward movement and downward movement is possible for this share. So for this I have taken the premiums, 4 premiums. So I'm not explaining detail about this, so if you want the detailed explanation about how I have done this analysis, so I'll post a separate video for this. So if you want that, make sure you ask me in the comment section, so that in next video we'll do video on this. So in the box you can see that this is based on the annual, so I'll just mark that. So this is annual positions, so we can see that maximum downward movement is around 468, whereas maximum upward movement is 4169. So most of the people will be shocked to hear that will it really go to 468 rupees. So let me take you 10 years back when the 2008 recession has occurred. We know that Bajaj Finance share, which was trading around 45 rupees, it has corrected almost 50% and it has reached 4 rupees. Right, 4 rupees. So almost it's a NBFC, and also it's belong to the finance sector. So since the lockdown is being extended, so the major impact will be on its business. So nearby there is no any positive signal for it, even though even the Nifty, I said that in my previous video, I believe that it should go to 9000 again. Nifty should touch the 9000. So people who didn't watch that video should go to the video and watch it once. I have given the various levels of Nifty also. So this is the annual targets. So similarly, if we consider the monthly targets, that is this May month, since I have taken the May month expiry, so we can see that the monthly downward can be 1789, and similarly upward movement is around 2846. So people who want to invest or who want to do trading need to focus on these levels, or any positional trader or any long-term investor should focus on this 1700 level. Okay, so similarly let's see this share in charts, and you know, try to find out the supports as well as the resistances. So let me take to the one day chart. So in one day chart we can see that it's currently taking its support around 1967. We know that recently it has tested the 1967. This is the previously it has tested once, and this is the second time when it has tested this 1967 level. So this is the very crucial support for this share, and it's currently trading there, but it's showing that it has to move upward. Even though the chart is showing somewhat upward movement, and you can see the RSI is also the money flow index also is pointing upwards, so it's showing that there is some volume also in it, but not that accurate volume. So when the MACD is also totally flattened, so no clear direction about this share, but we can see around 1967 as the support. So when it breaks this 1967 support, so the downtrend will start, and it will start moving down towards 1900 and followed by 1800 levels. So we have put a target that maximum in month it can go around 1762, right? So that's the base for it. So we need to keep that in mind. So again, we need to buy at that particular level, not selling. Okay, if you have any doubt, please ask in the comment section. So this is the one day chart. So let's see this in 1 week as well as 1 month charts also. So in 1 week chart also, we can see that when it's broke this 50 EMA level, so it started continuously falling. I have told in previous videos also, whenever any share breaks 20 EMA, so this is 20 EMA, so whenever it breaks 20 EMA, so we need to search for the selling opportunity rather than buying. Okay, that is downward, downtrend will start, so this should be kept in mind. Okay, so similarly we can see the different levels for it. It has broken this level, so it's signifying that it will definitely go down, but we can't tell what will happen, because if we see in multi time frame, we are seeing a support at 1969, so that should be kept in mind. Okay, okay, similarly you need to keep targets around 1900 1800. Okay, even though we consider annually, it's not a good stock. It's very good stock, but right time to invest is not this time. Okay, we need to wait for a good movement and the lockdown, everything should be cleared, when the coronavirus effect should be reduced, so that we can start investment. Although it's a very, very good stock, we know that Bajaj Finance has given huge returns to the investors also, but this time investing in this is not that good in my opinion. Buy on dips around 1700 1800 is a very good buy. Okay, so similarly when we go to the 1 month chart also, I have said that when it has formed a huge red candle and significantly now it's forming little bit smaller candles, it started and it's taking support at those levels as I given earlier. Okay, so focus on these levels and start investing and start buying on dips. Okay, in very less quantity rather than lump sum amount, so start buying in very small quantity. Okay, so if you like the video, so do like the video. Thank you.